All right, guys, so once you have everything outlined in Sharpie, you can see how I've started to go in with the thicker Sharpie and add some darker lines, and the thinner Sharpie or Micron and add some thinner lines. Now, this is that process of now I'm kind of deciding, where do I need some more value? Where do I need some contrast? Where do I need more detail? So maybe I go in and I add sort of some horizontal stripes, or I say all of these shapes kind of look like the same size. Maybe I need to break it up a little more. Now, this is that process of deciding, you know, what is my artistic taste? Do I want something a little more simple? For example, down here is very simple. Or do I want something a little more complicated? Now, I think a good tip is it looks really good if in a really complicated area, you have a lot more line. So it kind of saturates that area, it adds that contrast. Whereas in the hair, it's sort of up to me. Do I want a lot of texture or do I want something a little more simple? Do I want to add, you know, some details? Do I want some, you know, do I want to space things out more? Do I want more, you know, small, skinny shapes, for example? Now that, like, when I put the line closer together, it creates a darker value. So it looks more saturated, even though I'm not even shading anything in. Right here looks a lot darker than right here. We can just tell by the way that the line is so close together. So that is sort of our next step. We're outlining everything with Sharpie, whether that's thick or thin, and really trying to make those decisions where we're making this contour visually interesting.